Good morning, students of class 5. Students, I'm sure all of you are happy and healthy. Students, in my last video, I had explained exercise 2 of unit 8, nouns, gender of your English grammar book, and I had started with exercise 3. And I had explained and written the 3 sentences of exercise 3. Today, I'll be continuing with the remaining sentences of exercise 3 of unit 8, nouns, gender. So, all of you, please take out your English grammar book and turn to page number 34. Students, please take out your English grammar book, turn to page number 34, as I'll be continuing with exercise 3 of unit 8, nouns, gender. Students, first of all, I would like to revise exercise 2 so that we can easily continue with exercise 3. And please learn all the opposite genders, masculine and feminine, both the genders of exercise 2. So the first one is stag. The opposite gender of stag is hind. The second is duke. The opposite gender of duke is duchess. The third is rooster, and the opposite gender of rooster is hen. Fourth is buck. The opposite gender of buck is doe. Fifth is drake. The opposite gender of drake is duck. Sixth is colt. The opposite gender of colt is filly. Seventh is billy goat. And the opposite gender of billy goat is nanny goat. Eighth is gander, and the opposite gender of gander is goose. Ninth is groom, and the opposite gender of groom is bride. Tenth is father-in-law. The opposite gender of father-in-law is mother-in-law. 11th is lad, and the opposite gender of lad is lass. 12th is earl. The opposite gender of earl is countess. 13th is waiter, and the opposite gender of waiter is waitress. 14th is nephew, and the opposite gender of nephew is niece. 15th is salesman, and the opposite gender of salesman is saleswoman. And 16th is ram, and the opposite gender of ram is Eve. Now in exercise 3, that is rewrite the following sentences after changing the gender of the underlying words. Clear? Now, the first 3 sentences I had done, and today I'll be continuing the 4th one. But before I start with the 4th one, let's revise the first 3 sentences. The hunters attacked the he-bear and vixen. Now the underlined words are hunters, he-bear, vixen. So the opposite gender of hunters will be huntresses. The opposite gender of he-bear will be she-bear. And the opposite gender of vixen will be fox. So, our sentence will be, the huntresses attacked the she-bear and fox. Second, the washerman saved the son of a priestess. And the underlined words are, washerman, son, priestess. So, the opposite gender of washerman is washerwoman. The opposite gender of son is daughter. And the opposite gender of priestess is priest. So, our sentence will be, the washerwoman saved the daughter of a priest. Then the third one, the drake was feeding its duckling. The opposite gender of drake is duck. So our sentence will be, the duck was feeding its duckling. Now I'm going to start with the fourth one. And the fourth sentence, children, is the farmer had a colt and a he goat. Fine. The underlying words are colt and he goat. So now, जो हमें words change करने हैं, that are colt and he goat. Fine. He goat का क्या हो जाएगा बेटा? He goat का हो जाएगा she goat and कॉल्ट का मैंने आपको बताया था, हमने किया भी है, कॉल्ट का क्या हो जाएगा, फिलिंग, क्लियर। सो आवर सेंटेंस विल बी द फार्मर हैड अ फिली एंड अ शी कोट, क्लियर। द फार्मर हैड अ फिली एंड अ शी कोट, एंड फॉर डूइंग सच एक्सरसाइजेस यू नीड टू बी थरो विद द ऑपोजिट जेंडर। आपको जितने भी ऑपोजिट जेंडर है बेटा वो लर्न होने चाहिए, अगर लर्न नहीं होंगे तो कैसे करोगे। Called का opposite gender filly, he got का opposite gender she got. Fine. So the farmer had a filly and a she got. Okay. Now the fifth one. The wizard, witch का opposite होता है wizard, है ना, witch चुड़ैल, और जो उसका male होता है उसको हम wizard बोलते हैं. Who does the black magic? The wizard turned the boy into a doe rabbit, and the underlying words are doe rabbit, boy and wizard. Fine. अब हमें इन तीनों का ऑपोजिट जेंडर लिखना है। विजर्ड का ऑपोजिट जेंडर क्या होगा, विच, बॉय का गर्ल, डो रैबिट का बक रैबिट, क्लियर। सो आवर सेंटेंस विल बी द विजर्ड टर्न्ड द, सॉरी विजर्ड का तो ऑपोजिट जेंडर हमको लिखना है, विजर्ड का ऑपोजिट जेंडर क्या हो जाएगा, विच, डब्ल्यू आई टी सी एच, द विच टर्न द बॉय का ऑपोजिट जेंडर क्या है बेटा, गर्ल, इनटू आ अब डो रैबिट, डो का ऑपोजिट जेंडर बक होता है, तो हम यहाँ पे बक रैबिट लिख देंगे, क्लियर। So, our sentence is, the witch turned the girl into a buck rabbit. Fine? I hope everybody has done. Let's revise. Fourth one, the farmer had a colt and he goat. And we need to change the gender of colt, uske opposite gender filly, the opposite gender of he goat is she goat. So, our sentence is, the farmer had a filly and a she goat. Then the fifth sentence, the wizard turned the boy into a doe rabbit. The opposite gender of wizard is witch, boy, girl, and the opposite gender of doe rabbit is buck rabbit. Fine. I hope everyone has done. Students, again and again I'm repeating, or if you need to learn the opposite genders by heart. Jab tak aap learn nahi karoge beta, nahi aayega. Now the sixth one. The headmaster called my mother to talk about my progress. And there are two underlying words in this sentence. The headmaster called my mother to talk about my progress. I hope all of you are aware who a headmaster is. Beta, one or classes 1 to 5, primary section के जो teachers के head होते हैं, उनको अगर वो sir हैं तो headmaster बोलेंगे, और अगर कोई lady है तो उनको हम headmistress बोलेंगे. Clear? तो headmaster का जो opposite gender है, that is headmistress, and mother का opposite gender, everyone knows, father. Fine? तो हमारा sentence क्या हो जाएगा? The head mistress, the headmistress called my father to talk about my progress. This is our sentence. Clear? Headmaster में last में TE आ रहे हैं. But headmistress में जैसे waiter का waitress है ना? माँ उसी तरह इसमें भी TRE double S है. तो ये ध्यान में रखना. कुछ बच्चे क्या करते हैं? Headmistress. वो पूरी spelling ऐसे ही लिखेंगे. Head, फिर master और फिर ई डबल एस लगा देते हैं. ये गलत हो जाता है. इसमें मिस्ट्रेस में टी आर ई डबल एस होता है. ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है. क्लियर? सो प्लीज बी पर्टिकुलर अबाउट योर स्पेलिंग्स. हमारा सेंटेंस क्या हो जाएगा? द हेड मिस्ट्रेस कॉल माय फादर टू टॉक अबाउट माय प्रोग्रेस. ओके, नाउ द सेवेंथ वन. द एम्परर The emperor and his man servant went for a walk. अब इस सेंटेंस में हमको क्या चेंज करना? एम्परर एंड मैनसर्वेंट. क्लियर? फाइन. अब आपको ध्यान से देखना, इसमें हिज भी अंडरलाइन है ना? हिज हम यूज करते हैं मेल के लिए, तो जब हम यहां जेंडर चेंज करेंगे तो हिज भी चेंज हो जाएगा. अकॉर्डिंगली हमको ये इसको भी चेंज करना है. तो एम्परर का फेमिनिन जेंडर क्या होता है? ऑपोजिट जेंडर, दैट इज एम्प्रेस. द एम्प्रेस एंड हिज का क्या हो जाएगा? हर. द एम्प्रेस एंड हर. मैन सर्वेंट का क्या हो जाएगा? मेड सर्वेंट. एम ए आई डी मेड सर्वेंट. The emperor and her maid servant went for a walk. Clear? The emperor and his man servant went for a walk. Opposite kya ho gaya? Opposite gender ke saath sentence. The empress and her maid servant went for a walk. क्लियर? सो यू नीड टू बी थरू. और सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट बात है स्पेलिंग, है ना? एम्परर का क्या है? एम्प्रेस. हेडमास्टर का हेडमिस्ट्रेस. ध्यान रखो, जनरली जब हम फेमिनिन जेंडर में चेंज करते हैं तो आर ई डबल एस एंड में आता है. वेट्रेस, एम्प्रेस, मिस्ट्रेस, ये ध्यान में रखो. आप लोग एज इट इज स्पेलिंग उठा के उसमें आर ई डबल एस एड कर देते हो, जो गलत हो जाता है. सो बिसाइड्स लर्निंग the opposite gender, please learn these spellings as well so that you do not lose your marks. Fine? So I'll repeat, then I'll erase. The sixth one, The headmaster called my mother to talk about my progress. And the sentence with the change genders are, the headmistress called my father to talk about my progress. Then, the seventh one, the emperor and his men servant went for a walk. Change gender ke saath sentence kya ho gaya? The empress and her maid servant went for a walk. Fine. So now I'm going to erase the board and write the eighth sentence. The eighth sentence is, the prince was riding, the prince was riding his horse. The prince was riding his horse. And the underlying words are, which we need to change, prince and his horse. Clear? Ab. Ab iska opposite gender ke sang hoga, kya hoga? Prince ka kya ho jayega, beta? Princess. His ka kya ho jayega? Her. Aur horse ka kya ho jayega? Female horse is known as male. Hai na? Don't get confused. A baby male horse is known as colt. A baby female horse is known as filly. And adult ko hum horse bolte hain. Adult female ko hum mare bolte hain. Clear? To hamara sentence ab ho jayega. The princess was riding. The princess was riding. Kiska opposite kya ho jayega? Her maid. M-A-R-E. Maid is a female horse. Fine. So the princess was riding her maid. Clear? I hope everyone has done. Now the ninth one. My nephew is a school master. Now we need to change this. Fine. So, nephew ka opposite gender kya hota hai beta? Niece. My niece is a school mistress. School master ka opposite gender kya hoga? School mistress. Fine. Nephew ka opposite gender kya hoga? Niece. Students, please keep in mind, maximum of you pronounce this word incorrectly. Aap log niece ko nice bolte. N-I-E-C-E is niece. Koi bhi isko nice nahi bolega. Clear? Now I'll revise, then I'm going to erase. Fine? The eighth sentence is, the prince was riding his horse. And the sentence with the opposite gender is, the princess was riding her maid. Then the ninth one, my nephew is a school master. And then the sentence with the opposite gender is, my niece is a school mistress. Fine. I hope everyone has done. Now I'm going to erase this and I'm going to write the next one. And now the 10th one is, the landlady jante na, makan malkin ko bolte hain, asked the milkman brain milk. And the underlying words are landlady and milkmaid. Landlady, makan malkin, or opposite gender kya hota hai? Land lord. Milkman ka opposite gender kya hota hai? Milkmaid. Fine. So we will write the landlady ka opposite gender kya likhenge? The landlord asked the milkman की जगह हम लिखेंगे milkmaid. The milkmaid to bring milk. Yeah. The landlord asked the milkmaid to bring milk. Clear? The landlady asked the milkman to bring milk, and the sentence with the change genders are the landlord asked the milkmaid to bring milk. Okay. Now the 11th sentence. His stepfather was a gentleman. Fine. Now the opposite of stepfather is stepmother. है ना? स्टेप फादर स्टेप मदर आपको पता है ना. सपोज किसी के अपने रियल फादर या मदर की डेथ हो जाती है और अगर वो दूसरी शादी कर लेते हैं तो जो उनके दूसरे हस्बैंड या वाइफ है वो बच्चों के स्टेप फादर या स्टेप मदर लगेंगे. क्लियर? ओके. सो हिज स्टेप फादर की जगह हम क्या लिखेंगे? स्टेप मदर. हिज स्टेप मदर was a lady. His stepmother was a lady. Gentleman का opposite क्या है बेटा? Lady. तो हमारा क्या हो गया sentence? His stepmother was a lady. इधर था his stepfather was a gentleman. Opposite हमने लिख दिया. His stepmother was a lady. Fine. I'll revise, then I'm going to erase the board. The 10th one. The landlady asked the milkman to bring milk. And the sentence with the opposite gender is the landlord asked the milkmaid to bring milk. Then the 11th one. His stepfather was a gentleman. And then the sentence with the opposite gender is his stepmother was a lady. Clear? I hope everybody has done. Now I'm going to erase the board and write the last sentence of this exercise. Twelfth one. The bridegroom. Bridegroom ka meaning to sabko pata hai na? Dulhe ko bolte hain. The bridegroom was receiving the guests. Okay. अब ना bridegroom दूल्हे को बोलते हैं और दूल्हे का opposite gender क्या है बेटा? दूल्हे का opposite gender दुल्हन हिंदी में है, इंग्लिश में ब्राइड. तो हमारा सेंटेंस हो जाएगा द ब्राइड वॉज रिसीविंग द गेस्ट. क्लियर? We have finished our third exercise, that is writing the sentences again by changing the gender. अब बेटा इसमें सबसे important चीज जो आपको ध्यान रखनी है, that is कि अगर कहीं पे gender के हिसाब से अगर pronoun use है, जैसे हमने देखा हिस्टा, वहां हमने हर किया, तो आपको ये छोटी छोटी चीजें भी ध्यान रखनी है. Now all of you please turn to page number 35. I would like to explain you the tip of the day. All of you please turn to page number 35. Tip of the day, that is written in the blue box. And that says, most of the nouns denoting occupations are said to be of common gender. For example, artist, author, dancer, editor, engineer, lawyer, musician, novelist, principal, scientist, minister, etc. We say Deepika is an eminent actor, not actress. Okay, fine. अब इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि बेटा वो सारे nouns जो occupation मतलब कि कोई काम क्या करता है ना, जो हम काम करते हैं वो हमारा occupation है. For example, my occupation is of a teacher because I teach. मेरा occupation क्या है? I'm a teacher and I teach students. है ना? I teach students. तो वो जिससे कि किसी का काम पता चले, ऑक्यूपेशन पता लगे, वो सारे नाउन्स क्या होते हैं? कॉमन जेंडर होते हैं. कॉमन जेंडर का कोई ऑपोजिट जेंडर नहीं होता है, है ना. आर्टिस्ट, अब आर्टिस्ट मेल भी हो सकता है, फीमेल भी हो सकता है. देन ऑथर, ऑथर मीन्स अ पर्सन हु राइट्स बुक्स, दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी अ मेल और अ फीमेल. देन डांसर, मैन ऑल्सो डांस, वुमेन ऑल्सो डांस. Editor, that can also be a man or a woman. Engineer, boys can be engineers, girls can be engineers. Lawyer, boys can become lawyers, even girls can become lawyer. Musicians, yes, even girls are musician and boys are also musician. Novelist, जो novel लिखते हैं वो men भी होते हैं, women भी होते हैं. Principal, कई स्कूल के principals सर लोग होते हैं और कई स्कूल के principal मैम लोग होती हैं, तो दोनों होते हैं. Scientist भी मेल भी होते हैं, फीमेल भी होते हैं. मिनिस्टर मेल भी होते हैं, फीमेल भी. तो उनका हम ऑपोजिट जेंडर, जो जनरली ऑक्यूपेशन जो नाउन्स एक्सप्रेस करते हैं उनका कोई ऑपोजिट जेंडर नहीं होता है. एंड लेट्स लुक एट दिस एग्जांपल. अब बेटा इस एग्जांपल को आप ध्यान से देखो. द एग्जांपल इज दीपिका इज an eminent actor. Not actress. Clear? अब यहां पे ध्यान से देखो, यहां पे हमने क्या लिखा है. हम अगर इन जनरल बात करते हैं तो वी से दीपिका इज एन एमिनेंट एक्टर. हमने एक्टर बोला, दैट मीन्स हमने उसका ऑक्यूपेशन बताया. अब हम ऐसा ना सोचे कि एक्टर तो मैस्कुलिन के लिए यूज किया जाता है, बट क्योंकि वो एक्टिंग करती है तो जो नाउन्स ऑक्यूपेशन बताते हैं उनका हम कोई भी फेमिनिन जेंडर नहीं बनाते, उनके लिए हम ऐसे ही लिखेंगे. अब वी नो दैट दीपिका इज एन एक्ट्रेस, बट हम जनरल में बोलेंगे तो हम यही लिखेंगे दीपिका इज एन एमिनेंट. एमिनेंट इज अ मतलब बहुत जानी मानी, पहचानी, हुज फेमस, है ना, एक्ट्रेस. तो यहाँ पे हम एक्टर ही यूज करेंगे. तो आपको ध्यान रखना है कि जितने भी कॉमन नाउन्स होते हैं उनका कोई ऐसे अलग से मैस्कुलिन या फेमिनिन जेंडर नहीं होता है. और जब हम किसी का ऑक्यूपेशन के बारे में बात करते हैं तो हम, फॉर एग्जांपल हमने जैसे लिखा दीपिका इज एन एमिनेंट एक्टर, यहाँ पे हमने एक्ट्रेस नहीं लिख के एक्टर लिखा. क्यों? क्योंकि एक्टर बताता है कि वो एक्टिंग करती, शी एक्ट्स इन मूवीज, तो वो क्या हो गया, वो उसका ऑक्यूपेशन हो गया. सो ऑल दी नाउन्स जो ऑक्यूपेशन डिनोट करते हैं, ऑक्यूपेशन मतलब कोई क्या काम करता है वो डिनोट करते हैं, दे आर ऑलवेज सेड टू बी ऑफ कॉमन जेंडर. उनका मैस्कुलिन और फेमिनिन जेंडर नहीं, दे आर कॉमन जेंडर, क्योंकि वो मैस्कुलिन भी हो सकते हैं और फेमिनिन भी हो सकते हैं. फाइन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. I'll be continuing with the remaining exercise in my next video. Till then, please do learn all the opposite genders and learn and revise all the taught exercises. Thank you, students. Have a good day ahead.